The word istiqama in the Arabic language translates partly in English as steadfastness, but it has a far deeper meaning, because al-istiqama refers to everything that should be done being done, and everything that should not be done not being done. That is steadfastness. Amazing. That means everything Islam has come with, if I adopt it, then I am a steadfast person. And this is why one day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very, very serious, and he tells his companions, shayyabatni Hud, the surah of Hud. There is a surah called Surah Hud in the Quran. It has made me gray. Now, for your information, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not have more than 20 gray hairs when he passed away. They were black. When he passed away, he did not have more than 20 gray hairs. Anas ibn Malik says, we counted 14 gray hairs. Allahu Akbar. Beard and head included. So let's say in one narration it says less than 20. So for him to have grayed, and he is saying something has made me gray. What was the verse? Imagine, he was the highest of creation. He was the closest to the Almighty. And he is the chosen one. He is the Nabi, the messenger sent to all of us. He came with the message. We know that he had such a good reputation amongst the kuffar of Quraysh prior to coming with the message. And yet, listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him. فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ وَلَا تَطُغَوْا إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. Be steadfast, O Muhammad, as you have been instructed, and those who have repented with you. Be steadfast and do not go beyond the limits, for indeed He, Allah, knows exactly what you are doing. Allahu Akbar. Imagine if you had to tell someone, hey, be steadfast. They would tell you, what, did I do something wrong? Today when we correct our children, it happens. You tell them, son, make sure you don't drop the glass. Dad, have I ever dropped a glass? I remember. See, we thought there would be no laughter, but it came. MashaAllah. I think it's Malaysia. Something about the people. They say there was a dad, every time he told his son to do something, he would say, son, come here. Take this milk from here to the lounge and serve all the visitors. But hang on, one smack. And then he sends his son. The son says, dad, every time you smack me before you send me, he says, what's the point of smacking you after the milk is gone? Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So here you have the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being warned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Did he need the warning? The answer is no. So what do we learn from that? My beloved brothers and sisters, don't feel bad when you are warned, when you are corrected. Don't feel bad. The most perfect of creation did not feel bad when he was corrected, when he was admonished, when he was warned. He never felt bad. That is how you develop. If a person feels bad when they are told what is right and wrong, they will never develop. Someone says, you know what, I attended a lecture, but to be honest with you, it really hit home too much at me. I cannot attend another one because I was embarrassed. We are all in the same boat, my beloved brother. We are in one ship, my beloved sister. Notice I said boat when it was a brother, because it's a bit smaller and more cramped. We wouldn't like to be cramped up with the sisters, mashallah. So don't worry. We all hear things. We all need the example. I have a habit. We are taught that as a speaker, when you are speaking, add yourself to say, I need this more than anybody else, and then everyone else. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me steadfastness, and then everyone else. Ameen. Ameen.